We're getting ready for this first game of the day. As they mentioned, I'm Late Night Lyle alongside Mellow Joe.
It's great
and
to
we're
be here
live for day two of the South Central Regional Playoffs by the WFTDA.
And we're underway.
The Show Me Derby Q here in Kansas City. And first jam is off.
Number 999, Anna Maniac, out in front quickly. She's the lead jammer.
Beverly Kills also making her initial pass. Both girls are on their scoring run, but it is going to be Omaha able to post some points on the board first and break their goose egg. Omaha, the underdog in this bout, Mellow Joe.
Certainly, you know, a team like Houston, they've been around since the WFTDA was founded. They're an original member, so they've obviously got the experience factor coming into this one. But Omaha, no slouch in their own right. Anybody that can make it into the top 10 into this tournament, I mean, this is the capital of the rebirth of roller derby is this region. So any team that can make it into the top 10 seeds and into this tournament is a great team. So with skaters like Anna Maniac, as you saw there, just breaking through the pack with ease, they've got a good shot.
Top jammer, I'm a fire starter for Omaha in the red and black, and Radium DK for Houston, but it is I'm a fire starter through the pack. She's the lead jammer. Omaha dropped a huge loss in round one of day one yesterday, and Houston almost came back from a significant deficit to beat Atlanta. And pundits are giving this heavily in favor of Houston. But certainly right now, early on, the first couple of jams, Omaha's been able to control. We'll see if Houston is able to come back. Score 6-0. Coming up on the third jam.
The Omaha Roller Girls in the black jerseys. Houston in the white and pink.
It is Flying Maiden for Houston.
And McKillia for Omaha. Both trying to make their way through the pack now. McKillia trying to get through on the inside, but not having a whole lot of luck getting through the pack.
She's up against a three wall.
Making her work for it.
Rebel Ann really giving her a hard time as she goes to the outside. And Rebel Ann puts a hit on her coming out of turn two. But she's able to keep on her skates and still has the biggest advantage. Going into another lap, and still neither jammer able to break the initial pass. Flying Maiden getting caught in the back.
Rebel Ann just showing some tremendous skill as a blocker.
Now is Flying Maiden able to finally break through the initial pass to be on her scoring run and pick up the lead jam. Flying Maiden on the inside. Flying Maiden pushing up against Alabaster Girl. Getting recycled to the back, and Flying Maiden going to the penalty box with a track cut.
Track cut major.
That's going to give Omaha a power jam. There's 30 seconds left in this jam, so they'll be able to take advantage of this through this jam and into the next. Unless they pick up a penalty of their own. Mellow Joe.
Omaha off to a great start this morning with authority.
Houston, who's, as mentioned before, favored to dominate, so far being shut out, but of course, only three jams in. A lot can happen, but Omaha would be pulling up the upset of the tournament so far.
Looks like
the winner of this game will go on to face Gold Coast later on today.
Well, we're seeing a lot of fresh faces out here in the crowd.
Who had a fantastic game beating Green Country in the second game of yesterday.
Green Country's first appearance in a WFTDA tournament.
And that was an incredibly exciting game. We may talk about that a little later.
Animaniac now in a power jam for Omaha.
Catches the whip on the outside of the back straightaway. Makes a move to the inside and becomes the lead jammer. Beautiful move by Animaniac. Houston is on the board with 1 point. But it's going to be a grand slam for Animaniac. First grand slam of the bout and of the day to kick off and extend Omaha's lead. Another grand slam, double digits for Animaniac.
Another nickel in the bank for Omaha early on in this bout. Off to a nice start.
Oh, and she moves to the inside. Power jam is over, and she calls off the jam, but not before picking up triple grand slams, adding 15 more points and spreading out the lead quite a bit with a 22-point spread. 24 minutes left in the first half. I'm a fire starter lines up for Omaha to take advantage and continue the lead, where it's Beverly Kills.
Yeah, they're off to a great start this morning.
Trying to turn the tide for Houston.
I'm a fire starter on the line for Omaha.
Beverly Kills moves to the outside and makes an easy pass. A lot of confusion. Still no lead jam being called. Oh, the jam didn't even start. A whole lot of confusion on the track. As Beverly Kills made a full lap without being given the go-ahead. Bella Joe.
Yeah, now they're trying to make their way through the inside there.
And Beverly Kills now gets the lead jam signal as I'm a fire starter. Gets pushed back. And I'm a fire starter, not able to score points this round. No star on her head. But it's going to be a natural grand slam of sorts for Beverly Kills. If you're watching on WFTDA.com, which would be the place that you're watching, be sure to pick up the high quality stream. It is beautiful. We'll talk more about that as well later. And don't forget to fill out your brackets for the rest of the day and for North Central playoffs, which will be next week. There's still time to win. Lots of jostling coming into turn one. And Beverly Kills decides she wants another run at it as she backs up and tries to regroup, but ends up ending the jam, just adding two more to the score of Houston. And that's going to make it 23-10. Still in favor of Omaha.
Sharon Misery, the pivot there for Omaha. It's her birthday today. So a special birthday wish to the pivot on the track for this jam.
I stand corrected. The score had already changed. 23-8.
McKillia now on the line for Omaha.
And Brandade for the first time tonight, or this morning, for Houston as Brandade holding on the line.
Jams off to a slow start.
And Brandade pulls through the pack in the back straightaway. She's the lead jammer. Brandade in a power jam and has picked up a grand slam, reducing the lead to just 10.
Very short handed out there. They only have two. Trying to stop Brandade. And Brandade did.
I'm a fire starter sitting in the penalty box. Another grand slam, making it a 5-point difference. Pack drops down to a dead stop.
And it looks like we've got a track cut.
And we have a jammerless jam as a track cut sends Brandy to the penalty box. And there's no jammer on the track for Houston. Or excuse me, for Omaha. Trying to get some information as to what has happened to Omaha's jammer in that one. A couple of jams back to back where Omaha just not fielding a jammer. As soon as we find out, we'll let you know. Mass proposal being put on by Omaha as they have a jammer on the line now.
Animaniac, number 999.
She's in a power jam as she moves to the outside, but goes up against a full wall of Houston. Animaniac on the inside comes through to the front straightaway. Still has yet to make her initial pass. Looking to just pick up the lead here as she makes a fast move and does pick up the finger high in the air. And she now has control of the jam. Power jam is over.
Weaves to the outside, picks up another couple of points.
Picks up a full five, a grand slam for Animaniac. As she calls off the jam, let's see if she was able to prevent Houston from picking up any of their own, and yes, she does. 28-18, as Omaha leads by 10.
Look at those fresh faces on the bench there late night. Dr. Hauschka celebrates the fresh faces of the WFTDA.
Well, I'll tell you what, when I
they make a great ointment patch daughter, for bruises. So if you're a Derby girl watching, he's got the cure for your bruise. Dr. Hauschka for your Hauschka.
You can check him out at the booth over there. Pick up a pair today.
Now, is that favorite skates?
As we were mentioning before, big day yesterday. The game that that everyone was talking about, Green Country versus Gold Coast, which had approximately 9 lead changes.
It was an incredible bout.
And ended up in a nail-biter finish, sent Gold Coast to Kansas City. Kansas City, as expected, just dominated Gold Coast in that one, sending Gold Coast to play the winner of this game, which will end up in a battle eventually for fifth place. So Mass proposal being put on now by Houston as I'm a fire starter, jostles for position for Omaha.
Wicked sweep, the jammer for Houston.
Wicked sweep, first time this morning, as she makes a move to the front, tries to squeeze through the middle, pass Killa, and does so. Sweep is the lead jammer. Fire starter finding a hole on the inside, coming out of turn two. Both girls on their scoring run. And Sweep calling off the jam.
Yeah, as they reach turn one there, you could see her look back and saw I'm a fire starter hot on her heels there as she was making the turn, decided just to call it off.
Does your hottie need to be shiny? Hit up derbysupply.net and pick up your derby skins.
This next jam is brought to you by Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solutions.
Brand 8 on the line for Houston.
And jamming for 8.
It looks like
somebody's lost a wheel.
Well, that's not going to be a good time. You picked a bad time to leave me, loose wheel.
Late night, have you been able to figure out who's missing a wheel?
I have not. I'm trying to look, trying to see it. Looks like Molly Massacre possibly is the one that lost the wheel. In the meantime, it is Brand Aid who is the lead jammer. The defense has been doing a pretty solid job not letting the jammers out early, but it's been even on both sides as both sides have had their jammers struggle. But there's no struggle there as Brand Aid just glides through the middle of the pack coming through turn three to pick up a natural grand slam.
You know, so far late night, I think this has been a much tighter bout than we were expecting. The experience of Houston just weighs so heavily coming into this that not that we can all predict, but I think a lot of people's brackets would be messed up if Omaha were to walk out of here with a win.
I believe strongly that you're right. So far, it's been a somewhat predictable tournament. Not completely, but it's gone as expected in most of the games. I think certainly if you were not just betting on who would win, but what the point spread would be, if it continues like this, then everybody's bracket would be messed up. And big move.
Animaniac out in front.
With a burst of speed as she is the lead jammer. Animaniac looking to make a power move through the middle. Gets some help and calls off the jam. No points for Houston as Omaha picks up two more.
Late night, if we could go briefly back to the jam earlier where we had a jammerless jam briefly.
For two jams.
Yeah, Omaha's jammer skated out to the track without the helmet panty on the helmet. And as you know, you can't assume a jammer status in a situation like that.
Right.
And she picked up a penalty but had to serve it as a jammer in the following jam.
So when she came back out, there was still no jammer. There you go. Just forgot the jammer panty, something you almost never see at this level of play, but mistakes do happen. It is Brand Aid for Houston. She's the lead jammer.
I'm a fire starter, still at the back of the pack, trying to make her way through this wall of Houston skaters.
Puts up a hard hit up against Wendigo, but gets blasted to the back and only now makes her initial pass as Wicked Sweet. Tries to shoot me, Brand Aid for Houston. Looking to finally close this as we're into the second quarter of this game, and Houston, who was favored to dominate, has yet to have the lead, Mello Joe. Four more points, though, now for Houston, and we've got a three-point game.
Yeah, certainly the experience factor loomed large over this bout, but as you can see, Omaha really doesn't care how much more experienced Houston is. They're here to win.
Yes, they are. And if they keep playing like this, they may just pull it off. Certainly they've looked very sharp. They looked very sharp yesterday despite the loss, but is looking even better today.
The Blastigirl on the line for Omaha, but Houston out in front, number 19.
That's Becky Watchett, or Betty Watchett. She is the lead jammer. Looking to finally take the lead for Houston is Watchett, as Omaha still stuck in the back. Houston in white, Omaha in black. Betty Watchett goes to the inside, gets hit hard. And still unable to make a full pass. McKillia pushing her around, but she's able to get past her. And now breaks through the back for a natural grand slam, and Houston takes the lead for the first time in this game.
And now they've got an opportunity to expand that lead. Blastigirl, the jammer for Omaha, going to the box.
Power jam for Houston. And this is not at all what Omaha was looking for, as a second grand slam held high. Five more points posted on the board in double digits so far for Betty Watchett.
You know, Houston takes the lead here in this late lead change, and also in a power jam.
And, oh, it's going to switch.
Track cut.
That's going to send Betty Watchett to the penalty box and possibly allow Omaha to recover what they've lost here. But only 10 seconds left in this jam, and not a lot of time served in the power jam given up by Omaha in the first place. So won't be a really long amount of power jam coming up in the next jam.
Now that momentum can shift the other direction for Omaha, hopefully looking to take advantage of this power jam coming up.
While we're talking, if you like it, great, but talk ultimately is cheap. Take it to the track. Go to their website. Talk is cheap today and find out more. Mass proposal being put down by Omaha and a timeout being called.
You know, since we've got a second here, this track that they're skating on, it's a sports tile. Skate court, actually, to be more specific. You can take your league to the next level with skate court roller derby flat tracks. And on a track like this, I would think that the skaters are using a lower durometer wheel, probably between an 88 to 92, depending on your personal preferences and weight.
We certainly haven't seen a lot of slipping and sliding.
No, we haven't.
The girls have looked very confident and very sure of themselves on the court.
Well, you know, those girls are, when they're choosing their wheels, they're selecting Atom Wheels. Atom Wheels, the official wheel of the WFTDA.
Mellow Joe, we talked about Omaha's game against No Coast, but Houston up against Atlanta. When they played, Atlanta started to blow them out, and then Houston looked like they were going to come from behind and win it.
Right.
Made a great push there in the end.
Houston
ultimately
had an excellent rally towards the end, and they were not going down without a fight.
Absolutely not. It was a fantastic last quarter of the game. Atlanta ultimately proved to be the stronger team, at least in that game.
That's right. And if you're just joining the tournament on WFTDA.com today, you can upgrade to the high-quality stream, and it also opens up the archive of yesterday's bout. So if you missed that, you can go ahead and upgrade and watch that later at your leisure.
Iggy Cox lining up for Omaha. I'm wrong, that's Animaniac. Correction made as Omaha sets up the mass proposal up at the pivot line and gets ready to take advantage of what might be a power jam.
That's right, yeah, it's a power jam situation, and the Houston blocker, or excuse me, the Houston jammer in the box has already served some of their time, so they want to take that knee and get their jammer skating as quickly as possible, because they know they're not going to have a full minute in this power jam, so they've got to try and get the most out of it, try and squeeze as many points out as possible.
Well, and Houston's jammer is only in there for a short amount of time anyway, as she came in there with Omaha's jammer only serving a short amount of time on her jam. So the power jam won't last much longer than just a few seconds after the start of the first whistle. Omaha looking to start this jam off immediately. Let's see if it proves effective. Waiting for the first whistle.
Meanwhile, we were discussing skates and the surface that they're skating on. You know, the boots are an important part of that, too. Rydell Skates is your total package, though. Rydell Skates, the proud partner and official skate of the WFTDA.
Rydell, certainly the name on many of these girls' feet right now, if not most of them, as Animaniac is the lead jammer. Houston getting too far out in front, unable to block, and that's going to send Radium DK as a blocker for Houston in the white to the penalty box for getting too far in front of the pack. Animaniac through the pack, though, before the power jam ends and picks up a grand slam.
Yeah, what we're seeing here is the strategy that they did at the beginning of this jam is working. They took that knee, and they're taking full advantage of the power jam, or were able to, before it ended. Animaniac now picking up a few more points and calling off the jam.
She picks up a few more points, not just a few more, enough to make it a tie game in Omaha and Houston, tied in less than 10 minutes in the first quarter of first half. What an amazing turn of events, an unexpected turn of events for what may end up being the bracket destroyer.
So far this has all the makings of an epic nail biter.
I'm a fire starter for Omaha. Beverly kills for Houston. Kills on the inside. Fire starter on the outside. Fire starter goes to the front straightaway and tries to race her way past, and does so. That was the Angie Christ that she made it past, and she is the lead jammer. Omaha in control, trying to break this time.
I'm a fire starter with her skates on fire.
Brandade for Houston going to the penalty box as a blocker for Houston.
Narrowly able to call that one off before Houston's able to pick up any points.
And we're still sitting by the scoreboard, 39-39, with just less than 8 minutes left in regulation play in the first half. Fast proposal again being put down by Omaha.
Quickly out front on the inside before they even pass turn one.
Incredible, that's Wicked Sweet.
Number 30 for Houston.
And Rebel Ann sends Omaha's jammer to the ground just outside of turn four. Wicked Sweet through the pack and picks up a natural grand slam. Houston first to break the tie.
Wicked Sweet with another nickel in the bank, breaking the tie with authority.
And now is going to have an opportunity to extend the lead as she's in a power jam. The Blasta girl spinning him in the penalty box and being joined by one of her teammates, Daisy Mayhem, blocker for Omaha. And this could be a shift, a key shift that people will talk about at the end of the game. We'll see. Only 4 points on that pass for Wicked Sweet. A no pass, no penalty prevented the grand slam. In a track cut, we'll see. It doesn't get sent into the penalty box, but it does prevent a fifth point as she posts four more. And Houston starting to put the biggest spread we've seen so far since the initial one that Omaha had in the opening jams.
That's right. If there's anything we've learned from this bout so far, is no lead has been a comfortable one. And this one certainly can be overcome by Omaha if they continue to play like they have earlier in the half.
Not only are they going to do that, now Omaha's in a power jam of their own as Sweet sits in the penalty box, turning the power jam back over. This could be a game decided almost entirely by penalties. We'll see what Omaha does to take advantage of the power jam in this upcoming jam. And they're going to put star jammer Animaniac on the line to try to overcome the deficit that Houston just posted.
I don't know if you can hear it at home, but there are some enthusiastic fans behind our vantage point here. Animaniac now on the line for Omaha.
Animaniac wanting to make quick work of the initial pass. Goes to the outside. Animaniac looks to the inside. Can't find a hole. Full four wall of Houston. Putting a solid advantage as it goes to a three, but Animaniac, with a burst of speed, tries to go to the outside but gets pushed out of turn two.
She's having a hard time getting past this wall of white and pink.
Split pack for a while as it congeals. Animaniac may end up in a power failure here. As she goes to the inside of turn two and finally makes her initial pass to be lead jammer. Power jam is over, though, and it is a power failure. No points scored in that power jam.
She does have a slight advantage having the lead.
That's the first power failure I think I've seen this entire tournament.
Yeah, it's incredible. We've seen a lot of great roller derby this weekend so far and plenty more to come.
Animaniac looking to make her first scoring pass. It's Wicked Sweet who makes an initial. Animaniac only able to reduce the Houston's lead by two, bring the score 53-41. And a 12-point lead for Houston. 3.5 minutes left in play. Hello, Joe.
You know, earlier we saw someone lose a wheel, and thank goodness Sin City Skates is here on site. Sin City Skates are the Big Five skate techs. They will fix your gear or chat about new stuff. They've got all kinds of awesome gear, and they can give you all kinds of tips on what kind of gear would be perfect for you.
Absolutely. Look them up on Google, Sin City Skates. Back to the action. I'm a fire starter getting recycled to the back. It is Beverly Kills breaking through first, though, for Houston. She's the lead jammer. I'm a fire starter getting some trouble, getting a whip on the inside. Goes to the outside, threads the needle, and holds the line. Is able to make it and is on her initial pass. Beverly Kills makes a quick hop inside of turn one and picks up four, calls off the jam and extends Houston's lead to 16. No, to 20.
Houston very effective with that three-wall blocking strategy. Just an incredible amount of ability they've had to slow down the Omaha Jammers.
They've had to make some key changes, and I think Houston is probably very surprised. We'll see if they make any serious changes at the half to create a much larger deficit, or what Omaha does to surprise Houston even more, come back and steal the score and ultimately pull off the win.
Brandade now makes it through the pack first to be the lead jammer, Houston.
Brandade sneaking through. Animaniac taking a can opener in turn four and dropping to the ground, still unable to make her initial pass. Animaniac now on the outside, coming out of turn two. But it's Brandade on the outside as well. In the back straightaway, picks up four, calls off the jam, and starts to play some fundamental derby as Houston incrementally increases their lead, jam by jam.
That's right. If Houston can keep up this nickel and dime strategy of controlling the jam, picking up 4 points, calling off the jam, rinse, lather, repeat, they can get a lead and get comfortable and try and just stay ahead of Omaha for the rest of this bout. Now, that's always easier said than done if there's anything we've learned watching these tournaments of the Big Five this year.
Well, it always seems to come down to the fundamentals when you really want to make either a huge comeback or just steadily increase and keep the lead rather than some of the more spectacular things or relying on the power jam. I know I've been smacked by some roller girls, but typically we are in the middle of a team timeout called by Omaha.
Maybe they're discussing what kind of boots they need. You know, Vanilla Skates can take you to success with their leather Renegade and straight jacket boots. Somehow, I doubt they're discussing their boot selection, though.
Probably not. They are probably discussing their selection of where to put a boot in relation to Houston.
It's a very, very, very tight game, although there is a little bit more of a gap in the score than what we've seen so far. Make no mistake, it's still a tight game.
It
and
is.
These two teams discussing their strategy, taking a timeout to kind of slow it down. Let's talk about this for just a second. How are we going to pull out a victory here? Both of these teams right now taking full advantage.
Well, we saw it earlier. Omaha had built up almost the same amount of lead in the beginning of this first half. Houston took a timeout, and then Houston came back and now has a 24-point lead of their own. Let's see if Omaha's strategy, if their timeout, is going to pay off here. We only have a minute left in the first period.
I'm a fire starter, held up by that back wall.
Beverly Kills also held up and gets recycled to the back. But Firestarter gets pushed to the inside as Beverly Kills makes it through and is waved off. Kills is on her scoring run, but a no pass, no penalty prevents her from having control of the jam.
Let's see what I'm a Firestarter does here.
I'm a Firestarter going to almost look like she was going to a defensive position there, but she makes a burst of speed and breaks through. She is the lead jammer, calls off the jam right away, and prevents Beverly from picking up any more points.
Just in the nick of time.
His kills was right on the heels of Omaha's blockers.
We've seen some tough hits today, but thanks to Dr. Houchka, the WFTDA's official bruise healer, they can lose the bruise with Dr. Houchka's Ouch Aid.
That's right. I was talking to the people at the booth of Dr. Houchka just earlier. You can actually find their fine products at drhouchka.com or just Google Dr. Houchka. That's going to be halftime. Your current score, Omaha 41, Houston 65. Mellow Joe, did you expect this kind of game?
No, I didn't. Omaha is hanging in there like a hare in a biscuit, and do not count them out. They're going to be well rested coming out of this half and have a chance to regroup, come back to the track with a new strategy, and see if they can take it to Houston.
Fantastic way to start day two. And we're back here live in Kansas City for the WFTDA South Central Regional Playoffs, the Show Me Derby Q. I'm Late Night Lyle alongside Mellow Joe as we get ready for the second half of Omaha versus Houston, as Houston currently leads Omaha 65-41. Mellow Joe?
It's been an incredible bout so far, and if you're just joining us, Omaha is in the black jerseys with red trim, Houston in the white jerseys with pink trim, and it's been an incredible bout so far, so close.
It has. It's been a surprising bout. A lot of people, as we mentioned several times in the first half, kind of expecting Houston to run away with this one or certainly maintain a larger lead, but Omaha has had the lead through most of the first half. Houston only coming away with a 24-point lead into the last 10 minutes of the first half.
Houston refuses to let Omaha run away with this one, and Omaha likewise.
Your keys to victory, Mellow Joe, what do you think Omaha needs to do to get back into this, retake the lead, and ultimately come out with the upset victory?
I think the strategy for either team here is just to try and control those lead jams. Houston controlled 10 lead jams in the first half. Omaha with 8, and you kind of see that reflected in the score. And both teams with 3 penalties each has been a fairly low penalty bout, but every time it has been a penalty, it's pretty much a power jam penalty. And these are our unofficial tally, by the way. That's not the official stats. That's just what we can see from here. We don't always catch everything, but these two teams, really what they need to do is try and control that lead jam, pick up 4 points, call it off, just that nickel and dime strategy. Either one of these teams, if they can pull that off effectively, that's the team that's going to win.
It is. Now, Omaha did have a power jam opportunity that ended up in a power failure, and that's why we currently have Houston with a 24-point lead. Beverly Kills is the jammer for Houston in the white, goes to the outside, Animaniac for Omaha, and it's Animaniac out first on the back straightaway. She's the lead jammer.
Animaniac having a great day so far, leading several jams.
Houston, two blockers in the box, no one in the box for Omaha, and 4 more points for Omaha as they reduce the lead to 20. And this is the kind of game that if they're able to play consistently is going to get Omaha into the higher seeded bracket.
That's right. You know, coming into this, Omaha ranked 10th seed with Houston at 5th seed for the South Central region. And both of these teams looking pretty evenly matched right now. And I think that says a whole lot about the South Central region, about the skill level that these girls are bringing to these bouts this weekend.
Animaniac picking up her 4th intentional minor as a blocker for Omaha. So she doesn't give up a power jam. I'm a fire starter on the inside for Omaha. Takes a hard shoulder and gets pushed to the inside of the back straightaway.
Very good job not letting either team's jammer.
Neither team's jammer able to break through as Brandade gets held back. It is I'm a fire starter who calls off the jam as soon as she gets out. Brandade had not made it through the back yet. Excuse me, I believe it was Brandade who made it out and called off the jam.
Now we've got Betty Watchett on the line for Houston.
And McKillia for Omaha. Mass proposal set down by Houston. No back being called. McKillian quick to the inside, tries to make a move to the outside, can't find a way, but squeezes through the middle and ends up on her knees in the front straightaway. Quick to recover, but it is Betty Watchett who's trying to make the move now as the pack separates way out in front. And Omaha at risk of out of play blocking penalties. And McKillia going to the penalty box for a track cut. Power jam Houston.
Meanwhile, Omaha did a very good job of recycling the Houston jammer there in that pass, but
and still doing so as Betty Watchett still unable to make her initial pass. We may be seeing our second power failure of the day. Betty Watchett now, she's being waved off. A minor track cut prevents her from taking control of the jam. We're still at a 20-point difference. McKillia sits in the penalty box, jammer for Omaha. Betty Watchett looking to increase the score for Houston. Goes to the outside and makes an easy pass for a grand slam, and it's a 25-point game. The game is starting to get decisively more physical as Betty Watchett slips to the outside across one and two to pick up a second grand slam and go to double digits in this jam.
Yeah, Omaha's going to have to keep their head in the game because sometimes when you get behind, there's such a mental aspect to this game. And if they don't keep their head in the game, we could see them start to pick up penalties, get sloppy from frustration. And if they do that, they could hand this over to Houston.
They could. Daisy Mayhem proving her point as she goes to the penalty box for blocking out of bounds. McKillia back on the track. The power jam is over, but not before four more. Picked up by Betty Watchett for Houston. In Houston now with a 34-point lead. You know, I've said several times, in fact, I was talking to some fans yesterday about what a comfortable lead is in Derby. And
yeah,
there really is no such thing as a comfortable lead.
Yeah, this certainly isn't one.
This definitely isn't one. When it starts to be about a 50 to 60 point difference in the spread, then it's like, okay, it's going to be, you're getting into grounds that are certainly a little more difficult.
The trick is never playing like it's a comfortable lead, because if you look at a team like Gotham of New York, they never slow down. They always play like they're 10 points behind, always.
And time and time again, we'll see teams get a nice lead, even significant leads, 70, 80-point leads, relax, and all of a sudden that lead closes back up after a power jam or just some blockers going to the penalty box.
You know,
closes quickly.
We spoke about the mental game earlier, and we were discussing how Omaha has to not stay frustrated, but on the same token, Houston can't get too comfortable in their lead because they could just as easily hand it back to Omaha here.
Omaha playing like a team that could do so without much surprise in this bout. In fact, as they've been playing, it's a little bit of a surprise that Houston's been able to post the 34-point lead that they have now.
Yeah, certainly very close during the first half. Houston having some success late in the first half, and it's carried over somewhat into the early part of the second half, but certainly no time to get comfortable for either of these two teams.
Betty kills for Houston. I'm a fire starter for Omaha. As kills makes a move on the inside quickly to be the lead jammer before the pass of the pivot line. And that's some solid derby right there.
Incredible. That was a beautiful maneuver.
It was. Firestarter yet to make her initial pass. Firestarter trying to make it past the three wall and gets recycled to the back as she gets pushed back to the outside of the back straightaway. Prosecutor of Houston, blocker, going to the penalty box. Molly Massacre and Daisy Mayhem for Omaha already sitting in the penalty box. And it's a grand slam, a natural grand slam for Beverly Kills.
Another nickel in the bank for Houston.
I'm a fire starter now, finally on her initial pass. Ready to pick up some points, but likely will be unable to do so as long as Kills remains clean. And she makes another solid pass. Picks up four more for Houston. And calls off the jam.
This next jam is brought to you by Dr. Hauschka. Check out their website and their amazing bruise healing and skin care products. Dr. Hauschka, the official bruise healing and skin care product of the WFTDA.
It's drhauschka.com. I'm a fire starter who's picking up an intentional fourth minor to not give up another power jam, but it is. And a maniac for Omaha breaking through with tremendous speed to be the lead jammer. This time it's Houston's jammer getting caught in the defense of Omaha. And Anna Reksha through the pack as she picks up a natural grand slam. And wow! Oh!
What a spill.
That was Daisy Mayhem.
Into the suicide seats there in turn one. I don't think our cameras picked that up, but it was incredible.
Brand-Aid giving some fans a need for a Band-Aid. But it's another 4 points for Anna Reksha.
Anna Maniac.
Oh, excuse me, you're right, Anna Maniac. And a power jam for Anna Maniac now. This is a big opportunity for Omaha.
This could be the shot in the arm that Omaha needs to retake the lead here.
Brand-Aid goes to the penalty box for Houston, and she calls off the jam, picking up three more, making it 57-88.
That's an interesting strategy, what we just saw there. She called off the jam, so it looks like they're going to try and start the next jam with a fresh jammer and a power jam, I think is the strategy here.
Indeed, 3 points being added to Houston's score. 57-91 is the current score. 21 minutes left in the second period. We'll remind everybody to pick up the rest of this tournament, the Show Me Derby Q, as well as the next one in high quality. Just click that high quality button there as you're watching on WFTDA.com. A no pass, no penalty prevents I'm a fire starter from being the lead jammer, but she isn't a power jam as the pack a dead stop in turn two. Firestarter picks up a grand slam and adds five more to the score of Omaha. As Omaha sends a blocker to the penalty box. Power jam is over. Dead stop to the pack, and
pack moving as slow as molasses there.
Brand-Aid tries to break through the pack as quickly as possible, does so on the inside of turn three, and calls off the jam to stop Omaha's momentum here. And it's only going to take another mistake or two like that by Houston to put Omaha firmly back in this battle.
Omaha refuses to die.
Omaha.
They will not go down without a fight. Anna Maniac now on the line. She's had great success getting that lead jam tonight. And let's see if she can continue that.
Well, if it's anybody that's had great success for Houston, it's their jammer right now, Beverly Kills, as she breaks through the middle coming through turn one. And she's the lead jammer. Anna Maniac also through the back. Both girls on a scoring run as Wendigo blocker for Houston. Sits in the penalty box. Once again, Houston in the white and pink. Omaha in the black and red as Anna Maniac picks up 4 points, steals 4 points. It's a wash, four on both sides.
Didn't work out quite how Houston had intended there. Sometimes that happens, though. That fourth whistle is everything. Sometimes that fourth whistle is a fourth point for the other team.
It is. Beverly Kills rarely allowing points, allows a full four on that pass.
Yeah, both of these teams have done a really good job of not allowing any points for the opposing team.
Fairly consistent through the entire tournament. I'm a fire starter. Moves and a big spill. We'll see if either gets sent to the penalty box. It is going to be Brand 8 as a blocker. She'll get a low block major for that for Houston. I'm a fire starter as the lead jammer. And she's in a power jam. As Betty Watchett for Houston takes a seat in the penalty box. And this is what we were talking about just a couple of mistakes, Mellow Joe. The score, 95-68, still in favor of Houston, but another grand slam reduces that by five. And we're in a 22-point game. Make that a 17-point game as another grand slam picked up, and she's not done yet. Over a minute left in the jam.
I'm a fire starter, living up to her name, starting a fire here in Kansas City, Missouri.
Wicked fire starter as she goes for her third, up against a two wall, hits hard, breaks through and picks up at a third grand slam anyway, and we're at a 12-point game. And the crowd is starting to become ecstatic here in Kansas City. Who needs caffeine when you have derby like this, Melo Joe?
Oh, she almost picked up some more points there, but avoiding a track cut, she got recycled. Houston doing an excellent job with their recycling.
Houston
on
is.
This pass, especially.
She's having to go all the way back to the back of the back straightaway to make sure she doesn't pick up a track cut major of her own. And the power jam has ended as Betty Watchett is going to try to stop the scoring devastation here, given up by their mistake.
Houston, although they gave up some points on that jam, were effective at shutting down I'm a fire starter.
Fire starter. Very happy with her performance. Big smile on the face of I'm a fire starter. You can see her go back to the bench right there.
Gets an incredible reaction from the crowd here. Look at that fresh face.
And it pumps up the entire lineup of Omaha. And this could be bad news for Houston. That kind of energy can translate on the track if it's focused. These next couple of jams could be pivotal as Anna Maniac, star jammer for Omaha, lines up, but it is Beverly Kills out first. She's the lead jammer. Anna Maniac also makes a pass, and she is, looks like she's gonna hunt down Beverly Kills. Beverly calls off the jam. Goose eggs posted on both sides. First double goose egg jam we've seen in, I believe, this entire second half.
Yeah,
she saw one in the first.
She was hot on the heels there, but Beverly Kills was trying to pick up at least 1 point calling off the jam there, but it didn't quite work out that way. Sometimes it's a wash.
It is. You know, I've been watching exciting derby all weekend long, and there's pictures of it in oh, the crowd is ecstatic. I'll get back to that in a moment. It is Wendigo who's broken through. She's the lead jammer. A dead stop to the pack. A blaster girl only now making her initial pass for Omaha. As Wendigo gets recycled, she is on her scoring run, but a blaster girl catches up to her and limits Houston to 3 points. And we're back to a 10-point game right at the 15-minute mark of the second period. I'm a fire starter. Lines up against Beverly Kills. I was about to mention earlier, Mello Joe, a fantastic book filled with amazing pictures on roller derby. No Mercy. You can check out the new derby photo book. It's by Jules Axel Adams Doyle. Look up No Mercy or Jules Doyle online.
He's an incredible photographer, and if you're a fan of roller derby, visit any roller derby community websites. You've seen his work, and you'll see him here in some of the camera shots. Just look for the guy with the neon shoes. You'll know him when you see him.
On the outside, I'm a Firestarter makes a move, and I'm a Firestarter is the lead jammer. 10-point game. Beverly Kills also out of the pack, but Firestarter having an opportunity to put a little more spark in the heart of Omaha as she gets to the inside, calls off the jam, denies Houston of any points, and picks up. There's a timeout being called. Firestarter picked up three. We're down to a 7-point game.
Maybe during this timeout we can check out our magazine, 5-on-5 magazine, the official magazine of the WFTTDA.
How many T's are in there, Mello Joe? The WFTTDA. Just one.
I got a little stutter this morning. I'm so excited with all this derby action here. Yeah. Anyway, 5on5mag.com. You can order your subscription today.
I'm a subscriber. You should be too.
You know, a lot of the skaters are using derby skins. They love to make your hiney shiny. And a lot of the skaters you'll see this weekend wearing their custom-made derby skins. They can make stuff to order for you. I don't know if you happened to see Dump Truck yesterday, but unfortunately for our eyes, he has his own set of derby skins, custom-made.
Not just yesterday, any time in any picture ever, if you've ever seen Dump Truck. Fantastic announcer. So much fantastic talent, not just on the track, but off. And we're seeing that fantastic talent displayed right now on the track between Omaha and Houston. There is an 8-point difference now in the score after that timeout. Houston at 98, Omaha at 90. 14 minutes left on the clock. Both teams only have one timeout left, and that could prove critical in the final seconds of this game. But it's going to be, which one? Oh, it's going to be close. It's Animaniac, who's the lead jammer.
Lead by a toe stop. That was just incredibly close.
Calls off the jam as Brandade just barely missed edging her out. She was hot on her heels coming out of that back.
Neck and neck, man. That was hard to tell. We had to defer to the jam refs there just to see who was first.
It was.
You know, a lot of the girls got their skates from Roller Girl Skates. You can get yours there as well, rollergirlskates.com.
Mass proposal being put on by Omaha. Wicked Sweet taking an intentional fourth minor, but it's I'm a Firestarter through the pack, and Firestarter has been on fire this entire bout, and certainly heating up even hotter if Firestarter continues this rampage back to the lead. She's going to be white hot. Firestarter. Firestarter's in a power jam. Another big opportunity
recycled
by for Omaha, given up by Houston.
Texas is going green because they've done a lot of recycling today.
They have Firestarter through the pack. It's a grand slam for Omaha, and we're down to a 3-point game with a minute left here. If Firestarter can stay clean, and that's exactly what Omaha did not need. A track cut on the inside of turn three sends Firestarter to the penalty box.
Firestarter flashing that beautiful smile. You can see her Pro-Tech Dent mouth guard.
Quick hop for Beverly Kills as she gets back into this. Needs to make an initial pass, and that was surely the jam to give Omaha back the lead, given up by a track cut on the inside. Beverly Kills made her initial pass. Looks to get past Massacre of Omaha. Finds, wiggles her way through the back straightaway and picks up a grand slam for Houston. Back to an 8-point game.
What an incredible bout so far.
Houston crosses the century mark, 103-95. As we near the 10-minute mark in the bout. If you're watching live on WFTDA.com, awesome. You're probably just as happy as I am.
We've seen a lot of awesome skating, and they're doing it on Rydell Skates, the official skate and proud partner of the WFTDA.
Brandade looking to finish off this power jam as it ends as soon as I speak it, but she is through the pack. She's the lead jammer, fire starter back on the track. This could be decided by a final power jam if either side gives it up here, but there's still plenty of derby to play with 10 minutes. But Brandade with a natural grand slam through the pack. I'm a fire starter, is in the pack, has not yet made her initial pass.
I'm a fire starter just hung up in this wall of Houston skaters.
I'm a fire starter, unable to break the two wall up front.
And looks like another grand slam.
Another natural one, 10 points for Houston. A dime, as you would say, Mellow Joe.
That's right, putting a dime in the bank this time. Making it very 15 points now. A 15 cent piece? I don't know.
And this. Oh no. I'm a fire starter back in the penalty box. And 20 points. For Brandade.
We could be looking at the jam that decided the game late night.
And another one that was at least 20. It may have been the unicorn, the full 25. That may be, it's not the first unicorn I've seen this tournament. Nashville posted one yesterday. Had a 25-point jam put up by Rambo Sambo of the Nashville Roller Girls.
Wicked Sweet now on the line for Houston. She's going to start in a power jam.
That is not the scenario at all that Omaha wanted, as they've given up over 30 in the past two jams after bringing it to just a 3-point game. Wicked Sweet looking to make her initial pass. Get shoved around up against a three wall, but they get too far in front of the pack, with the pack being called still back in turn two. They have to let her go. The Wicked Sweet is the lead jammer.
She's had a pretty good day so far, and perhaps she's trying to get that MVP award. The 2011 WFTDA MVP gets a one-week getaway to Mexico thanks to Union Vacations.
A grand slam for Wicked Sweet, as Houston continues to set the standard now. And a second one. Power jam is over. I'm a fire starter. There's, fire starter getting clobbered in turn one. And that's going to send Rebel and blocker for Houston to the penalty box. Firestarter picks up a minor back block in there, but Wicked Sweet picks up another 5 points, the preferred thing to pick up of the two.
Now that was a pretty hard hit we saw, and I think what I would use for that is some Dr. Houchka's Ouch Aid. You can lose the bruise with Dr. Houchka's Ouch Aid, the WFTDA's official bruise healer. We'd also like to thank Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing software.
We appreciate your support.
We appreciate all of our sponsors. We want to remind you, again, if you haven't filled out your brackets for the rest of the tournaments, including North Central's coming up next week in Indianapolis, or the World Championships in Denver, Colorado, go to the site you're on right now, WFTDA.com, and fill those out. You could win.
It's a bracket bonanza.
It is. Beverly Kills on the outside, or excuse me, on the inside, coming through turn two is the lead jammer. And what was a three-point game has now become quickly nearly a 50-point game.
It's almost like Houston flipped a switch.
Well, it was really the thanks of three power jams given up by Omaha, right literally as they were within striking distance of taking back the lead.
You know, as close as it's been and as crazy as these tournaments have been, I still wouldn't count them out yet.
No, absolutely not. A 50-point lead with 5 minutes left in the game isn't insurmountable, but now with another grand or power jam given up by Omaha and Beverly Kills being on the track for this power jam and posting another grand slam, it's looking less and less likely for what has been a phenomenal game for Omaha up until this point.
Axel Rogue, jammer for Omaha in the penalty box. Not where they want to be in a bout that was very, very close.
But it's where they've commonly been for the past 4 minutes.
This bout, as close as it's been, has been a textbook study on jammer penalties and how it affects the game.
Another grand slam, double digits for Beverly Kills as the pack crawls to a stop. Kills up against Molly Massacre, tries to push through and gets sent to the ground coming into turn one. Power jam is over. Axel Rogue rejoins the pack, but not before another grand slam for Houston. And Houston now at nearly a 70-point lead. And this is a lot closer to what I think pundits and predictors were thinking this game was going to go.
Yeah, it's starting to look more like the predictions now, but certainly it's not reflective of the rest of the bout.
It has been a phenomenal bout that has been given away by Omaha by giving up several power jams. Animaniac calls off the jam. She was the lead jammer there, even though Brandaid had made it through the pack. Brandaid was not the lead jammer, picking up a minor back block, getting through the pack.
Flying through on those Atom wheels, the official wheels of the WFTDA.
3.5 minutes left in this period. Just 3.5 minutes left in the game. 95 to 165, Houston. I'm a fire starter, lining up against Wicked Sweet. Fire starter for Omaha. Wicked Sweet for Houston. Houston in the white, Omaha in the black. Wicked Sweet almost jumping the line too soon, has to yield to Firestarter, but Sweet is able to break through the pack first anyway and is the lead jammer.
Got a tightly sealed pack as we've got a spill in the front straightaway.
Goldie blocks. Goes to the penalty box for four minors, but it is Wicked Sweet going to the penalty box for a major forearm, and this is a power jam for Omaha. but it might be a little too late.
This Power Jam's brought to you by Roller Girl Skates. Check them out, rollergirlskates.com.
Coming up on the two-minute mark is I'm a Fire Starter. Looking to create the story of the Big Five here. But will it prove to be too much of a mountain to crawl?
Sharon Misery taking a big hit.
Taking a huge spill, and Rebel Ann getting sent to the penalty box for
track
it.
Cut. Got a track cut on the jammer. I'm a Fire Starter now in the box, and it shifts back in Houston's favor.
I'm a Fire Starter who, this is her fourth power jam that she's given up today. She was the top scorer. But at some point, it's been the power jams that has really killed Omaha here in the last 10 minutes of this game. The jam has ended. Omaha picking up a few more points. But Houston will start this next jam off in a power jam of their own with Firestarter again in the penalty box.
You know, for our fans watching at home, there's a great way to learn the rules of roller derby with the Splendland Media Rules app. You can get that on your iPhone, and it's an incredibly easy way to learn the rules, and you can even bookmark rules, so if you've got a friend that's a ref, you can ask him about it, like, hey, what's up with this? Can you explain it to me? It's great. Great way to learn the rules. That's from Splendland Media.
Brandade through the back. She's the lead jammer for this power jam, but I'm a Fire Starter out of the box. You're seeing I'm a Fire Starter there in front with Brandade there in the back as they reach the pack. Initial pass being made by Fire Starter. Brandade calling off the jam and 0 points on both sides, but only 12 seconds left in the game. And a timeout being called by Omaha, their final timeout.
That's going to give us one more jam.
Indeed.
We'd like to thank our tournament partners. I don't know what's going on here. Something in the water, I think. Green Monster Roller Sports, Fast Girl Skates, Merch Mama, Five Stride Skate Shop, Derby Supply, Flat Track Revolution, Derbalife, and Derby for All. Thank you so much to our tournament partners that helped make this awesome tournament possible.
It's interesting, Mellow Joe, throughout the first half, we were talking about how we did not expect this type of game, how we didn't expect how close it was, how we didn't expect Omaha to lead in the first 10 minutes and play so fantastically. And then by the time we got 10 minutes into the second half, it was commonplace. We were expecting the close game. And now, what was originally expected has become the unexpected as Omaha leads by 72 points.
Omaha's not leading by 72 points.
Did I just say that completely wrong?
It's okay, because it was so back and forth.
It was so back and forth. Houston leads Omaha by 72 points. And it's going to be a power jam for Omaha in the hands of Star Jammer Animaniac. Beverly Kills sitting in the penalty box.
Animaniac looking to reduce the deficit here in this final jam.
She's only got a minute 30 to do it. The game is all but decided, but that doesn't mean that a fantastic jam can't be played anyway, and certainly Animaniac is one to put on that fantastic jam.
This crowd, very loud, cheering her on as she takes a spill in turn two, three.
Animaniac on the outside makes a quick move, fantastic lateral movement. And she calls off the jam after one grand slam, allowing Omaha to cross the century mark of their own. But very well done. But you have to wonder, Omaha, it wasn't so much Houston's skill, not to take anything away from it. But Omaha just getting a little sloppy, giving up several power jams there
right
in the last quarter and letting this one go.
Well, before the bounce started, we talked about that experience factor that Houston brings to the table as a founding member of the WFTDA and how that would be hard to overcome. Yet Omaha, during the first half, just completely threw that out the window, hung in there, and it was as the second half began is where Houston started to run away with it. Omaha still hanging in there, though, but it was just that series of power jams where Houston was able to take a commanding lead. And now sits Houston 170, Omaha 103, your final score from Kansas City, the Show Me Derby Q.
Hi there, Electric Blue here live on WFTDA.com. I'm here with Angie Christ of the Houston Hard Knocks, actually All-Stars now, formerly a executioner, first time regionals with the Houston All-Stars. Angie, it was looking a little rough out there. Omaha coming in early with a commanding lead. You pulled it together in the second half of the first period, and then it looked like Omaha was going to come back. What are your thoughts on how that game ended up?
Well, I'm happy about the way it ended up, but Omaha played a great game. They played really well together, had a great defensive wall, and their jammers were pretty phenomenal. So it took us a little while to adjust, but we did well. We played as a team and came back strong in the second half to finish it up.
You sure did, yeah. Always that blocking is a much harder hitting than you think it is out there. Omaha doing a really good job keeping up those walls, but it looks like you did make those adjustments that you needed to do. Bringing the lead now to 170-103 was the final score on that. So now you're going to go on to play Gold Coast, which is the surprise team of this tournament, I think. What do you think? Have you been watching them? What do you think about that team?
We have watched them, and actually we had a chance to play Gold Coast earlier in the season. They're also big hitters. They have some really good big hitters. So we are going to try to go out and do how we finish the second half and start that way from the first whistle in the next game.
Well, there you go. Congratulations on this game, and good luck in the next one. We'll see you back at 6 o'clock tonight playing Gold Coast. Thanks so much. Back to you, boys.